For this video, we're going to go into some detail on cutting and etching both carbon steel and aluminum welds. Let's do it.
In a previous video, and I'll link it up right about here, I experimented using this very same technique for all positions: flat, horizontal, vertical, uphill, and overhead. I didn't get a chance to do a cut and etch test for that video, but the puddle, the arc, looked something like this. I was trying to keep the arc on the leading edge of that puddle. It looked like it was penetrating okay, but the only way to know for sure is to test it. This is just one of several methods that you can use for vertical uphill welding. I've found it works pretty well. Also, a series of triangles works, but what both of them do is they keep the arc in the front or leading edge of the puddle. So I didn't get a chance to do a cut and etch for that particular video, and I decided to put a whole bunch more passes on each one of these T-joints here so that I could also show the cut and etch on how it will reveal lack of fusion or cold lap in between passes. So when we do the cut and etch on this, we'll not only see the penetration in the root of the joint or lack of penetration, but we'll also see all the different passes and the layers and how they stack in there. There are several different ways you can use to cut. It's just best to use a method like a bandsaw or a chop saw or something that gives you a fairly smooth surface so that you don't have to do a whole lot of grinding. This dry cut saw leaves a fairly smooth surface, so I'm going right to the belt sander with a 50 grit belt. That will give me a nice smooth finish, nice flat finish. Not quite smooth enough to get detail in the etch, so I'm going to go ahead and go to a 120 grit, and I'm going to crisscross the scratches so that I'll know when I got the 50 grit scratches out of there. You can already kind of notice, you can see a little bit of detail already on where the weld begins and where it ends, but I'm going to go ahead and take it down a little bit smoother, starting off with a brown Scotch-Brite, then stepping it down to a red Scotch-Brite pad, and then a gray one. And that should be about enough. For etching, I'm going to be using this passivation solution made by a company called ChemClean. Another easier to get solution is just naval jelly rust remover, and I'll show that in just a few minutes. But you can see how this really, really reveals each weld nugget and how much penetration I got, and also even each layer of weld and whether I got adequate fusion in between layers or whether I got cold lap. Then I take a picture and I pull it into some type of editing program and snap lines on it so I can tell where the root of the joint is. You don't need any super special editing software to do this. You could pull this image into something like Microsoft Paint, even it would draw lines like this. I did an overhead multi-pass T-joint not too long ago and just want to show you that this is a fairly rough finish, but it's still etched just fine. Best practice, though, is to get it just as smooth or as close to a mirror finish as you can with the equipment that you have. You'll see more detail if you get a fine finish, especially if you're going to be using this Loctite Naval Jelly Rust Remover. It works just fine. It takes a little bit more swabbing to bring out the detail, but it does the job. It's easy to get at any big box store. And it also helps, once you're finished with the etch, to kind of play a light source at different angles around it. You'll see more detail. Let's take a look at aluminum now. Aluminum is really easy to cut and really easy to etch. Some time ago, I was testing out different waveforms on aluminum. What you see here is called advanced pulse, also called mixed TIG, where it's alternating between AC and DCEN. I had read about all kinds of claims on how much penetration it got. I wanted to see for myself. So I compared it against all the other waveforms like triangle wave, soft square, advanced square, whatnot. I cut this just using a hand grinder and a cutting disc, and then I polished it just like normal, taking it all the way down to a blue or gray Scotch-Brite disc. I labeled them so I wouldn't mix them up, and you can see that the major waveforms like triangle, soft square, advanced square were all very, very similar. But when I got to that advanced TIG, where it was alternating between AC and DCEN, what a difference. So I got to test it and see for myself the difference in penetration instead of taking somebody's word for it. So then I also welded this quarter inch lap joint by hand, and that way I could get an idea of what it would do with filler metal added. And again, tested it, got some results in a matter of minutes. I thought I would weld another quarter inch lap joint using a 200 amp inverter machine. Full pedal, 200 amps, quarter inch. I'm using a big 1/8 filler metal. And To me, it looks like it's not quite getting in there. Like there's definitely a little bit of a void on there in the root of that joint. I'm kind of packing filler metal in there. I know it's not as hot as I would like it, but for the purposes of just correlating the puddle and the arc shot to the actual cross section, I thought it would be interesting. So I cut it with that same dry cut saw. I went right to 120 grit, right to the red wheel, followed by the blue wheel or gray wheel, and then I'm using straight up easy off oven cleaner for the etchant here, and it works just fine for aluminum. Doesn't take very long either. I got a fairly good polish on this. Now I got a result, and not only do I have a little bit of straight line effect toward the root of the joint, but I got a little cold lap out by the toe here. Again, I snapped some lines once I pulled the image in to see exactly where the root of the joint is. I got some penetration here and there, but not what I would want to see. Now, this I know is not going to be good, so I'm doing this on purpose. I dropped the amps by 50. I'm slamming some big 1/8 rod in there, and you can see I'm tunneling. I'm getting lack of fusion at the root of the joint, but we're going to see exactly how much, because you just saw that. Now you're going to get to see the cross section here immediately. No surprise there. I knew there was going to be some lack of fusion. I did not know I would have as much porosity as we see there, but that is why we test. We get a lot of information, and one test is worth 100 opinions.